Okay, we're out here in the middle of the desert. This will be my Christmas and New Year's video. I got the anti-shake on, so I don't know how this video is going to turn out. I hope it doesn't screw it up. Anyway, hope you all have a Merry Christmas. I'll be working Christmas Day from 2 to 10 at night, unfortunately. There's a bigger cockatillo. Here's a saguaro skeleton that's been dead for a long time. I like to get a couple of those pieces off of there. I didn't bring my machete. It's in the car. Here's the Palo Verde tree, and we got some mistletoe. See, this mistletoe is like a fungus, not a fungus, a growth that will destroy this tree because it'll start growing everywhere and it'll just kill it. And you can see what it looks like. It's got those little things on it. So that's mistletoe. It grows on these types of trees here. And you have to cut them off in order to save the tree. There's a wash right here in the middle of the desert. It's a little one that goes that way. There's some footprints. Not sure what it could be, a coyote. Not sure what it is. Very peaceful out here. Okay, here's a saguaro. Now here's something I have never seen before. They got some other cactus, prickly pear I believe, cactus growing out of this cactus because a bird must have made a hole here. And they were bringing nuts back and crapping nuts, I guess. Not nuts, seeds. And eventually the water, you know, hit the seed and whatever, so now you got cactus, different type of cactus growing out of the saguaro, which I have never seen before. There's probably a bird in there. That stuff you just don't see. Here's some jumping cactus. Haven't seen any coyotes or pretty much anything except birds. Gotta watch where I'm walking because there are a lot of little jumping cactus strewn about on the desert floor due to wind and holy shit, look at this. I gotta be careful not to step on it. A jumping cactus died out, but a pack rat built his nest under there. There's a few holes, but that's where the pack rats build their nests, so he's safe from predators under there. There's more jumping cactus. You gotta look down because it's everywhere, pretty much. Whoa! Almost stepped on it. Jumping cactus everywhere. Another pack rat nest. Wow, I gotta be careful. Here's a weird looking saguaro. It's got all arms that are come down and then up. You don't see that too often. This is what jumping cactus skeleton looks like. Basically, you know, there's not one around here. This is a form of jumping cactus too. It's a different type. There's at least three. Oh, there's some wood over there. I'm gonna go check that out. I thought there might be some good wood over here, like driftwood or whatever. Not driftwood, but, you know, like jumping cactus skeleton, but I did see something moving in there, and it's probably a pack rat. But now that I'm looking over here, here's a bunch of cans that are shot up. Actually, I don't know if they're shot up or somebody was eating them years and years, maybe 100 years ago or whatever. This might have been a, who knows what. They might have been mining or trying to mine out here. Yeah, I think there is a pack rat nest in there. There's a big barrel cactus. The birds will peck into that and get the seeds out of this. And then if they drop around, you'll start to see little ones growing. I have a few at my house growing around my barrel cactus. I don't really see any here. Probably because there's more birds to eat up the stuff. But that's what a lot of the wildlife lives on, these seeds here. Here's a perfect saguaro. Got the two arms perfectly set. Almost walk right by this. Here's a nice saguaro skeleton. I'd like to get that home, but of course I'd have to drag it out of here. Plus you're not allowed to take him anyway, so. But that doesn't stop anybody. This one's pretty old too. It's starting to come apart. But this is it. This is what they used to do. They would just follow this river, pan for gold. And you can get it out of here. You might get like a, I would say, a thimble full. If you're lucky, you could spend months out here. My brother did it about 10 years ago. I think in like a year, he might have gotten a very small, half a thimble full, if that. You know, but it's out here. All right, getting rid of some excess water. I brought a lot of water with me, and I'm almost out. So never waste your water. Always dump it on a cactus or a plant. You learn out here to not waste your water. Of course, I brought a lot of extra. This one just happened to be too warm to drink. Well, here's another smaller Ocotillo, but it does have the green leaves still on it. I guess it means it's getting some sort of water over here. That's pretty good, because as you can see, this one, no leaves. This one has leaves. And they usually get pretty big. They cover it pretty much. It's a pretty interesting plant. You could dig this up, put it in your backyard a couple months, replant it, and it'll still grow. So that's it. It was a good hike. First one I've done in a while. And it won't be the last. I'm gonna start getting my butt back out into the desert.